this guy, love him from The Price is Right, the famed announcer, Rod Roddy. This one's easy. Hey, Rod, L. DeBarge called. He wants his jacket back. All right. Oh, Tony Curtis. Are you kidding me? He hasn't been on in a while. Hey! Hey, it's Rod Roddy. Hey! How you doing?
Hey, Craig.
Let's go have a seat.
I hear you want to interview me, is that correct?
I want to interview you, yeah, I'd love to.
Go ahead.
Tell me about your next project.
You know what, Kilborn? Your interviewing is piss poor. Screw you, just do the news, okay?
In the News is brought to you by me, Rod Roddy, the Price is Right announcer with the L. DeBarge jacket.
I want to set you up. I know I think you're single, right?
Yeah.
I want to set you up with somebody besides the guy in the back row. I want to set you up with a gentleman in the industry who's a little older, a little more sophisticated. And then we're going to pay for a date for you guys to go out on, okay?
You're frightening me.
Here we go. We're going to have him in silhouette over here. Hello, sir.
Well, hello, Craig.
Say hello to Tara Reid.
Hello, Tara Reid. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm going to ask him a few questions. See? And again, if you don't want to go out with him, I'm your friend. He understands that. I said Tara is very picky. You don't have to go out with him. Sir, are you in the industry?
Oh, sort of.
Okay. Do you make over $40,000 a year?
That's why I'm sort of in the industry, Craig.
Okay. Are you married?
Not tonight. Okay.
Do you have any questions for him? Are you
scared?
To death? I tell you what I'm going to do right now, because I can tell, your big brother's put you on the spot. We're going to let you meet this guy. Don't decide now. When you meet him, I'm going to tell you the possible date you guys could go on, okay? It's not much, believe me.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, say hello from The Price is Right. Announcer Rod Roddy is right here. Watch the monitor.
Lovely. Absolutely lovely.
If you guys go out, this is where you're going.
Oh.
That's right, Tara. The Late Late Show will provide ground transportation in the car of a temporary receptionist. 1980-something Volkswagen Rabbit, compliments of Masha, our receptionist. Rod will then whisk you away for cocktails at the Hard Rock at the Beverly Center, followed by a romantic dinner at legendary El Coyote, where we will pay for two delicious entrees and a side. Gratuity is not included.
Oh.
Okay? Enjoy your date, Tara. There it is, right there. Don't decide now. Think about it.
Okay.
Just think about it. But remember, I think you're beautiful.
Okay. I wouldn't go out with him either. All right, we'll be right back with five questions. Tonight on a very special Late Late Show, our annual Thanksgiving Roundtable with my family, Tom Sully Sullivan, a.k.a. the Nards Guy. From the King of Queens, Kevin James, KJ. From The Price is Right, Rod Hot Rod Roddy. And live from Stuttgart, Germany, where she's just lost again in the first round, Anna Ofer Kournikova. It's all coming up next. Ladies and gentlemen, now, no time to rest. We are moments away from the round table, and the participants are arriving. And who is here? Is Kevin James here yet? Yeah? They're all here? Okay, we're ready then. Apparently, we are ready to go live to Craig Kilborn, who is there, for the 2001 Thanksgiving Round Table Live. Here we go. Welcome to the Thanksgiving Roundtable. Again, let's meet my family. Tom Sully Sullivan, a.k.a. the Nards Guy. From the King of Queens, Kevin James. Jimmy Jam James. From The Price is Right, Rod Hot Rod Roddy. live from Stuttgart, Germany, where she just lost again in the first round, Anna Ofer Kournikova. I'd also like to introduce the real stars of the round table, the food. First, a nice gift, a 12-pound free-range turkey. Compliments from everyone's favorite New York-based dysfunctional husband and wife sitcom, Everybody Loves Raymond. Stuffing is compliments of Librettery on La Brea, candied yams from Ralph's, mashed potatoes from The Sputtery.
That's right, Craig, The Sputtery, with five Hollywood locations. Visit our main store on Sunset. Whatever your favorite type of potato, you'll find it at The Sputtery.
Okay, guys, how were the introductions?
Oh, they were great, Craig. I always like meeting my food before I eat it. Okay, can we pick it up a little bit? Huh? I got two more Thanksgiving roundtables after this.
Okay, all right. Roddy, introductions, did you like them?
Oh, I liked them. Great introductions, Craig. I don't quite get introducing the food. There's a lot of stuff edgy on this show that I don't quite get. And by the way, my wife's the only one that can call me Hot Roddy, okay?
Frankly, I feel introducing the food is a little retarded. And besides, the thermometer on that bird hasn't even popped yet. I wouldn't touch it. It's probably got scurvy.
Right. You know what? I never wait for those things to pop, all right? The outside's brown. That's all you need.
Wait, why hasn't the thermometer popped? What's going on here?
It's undercooked. Who is in charge of cooking the turkey?
I think Rod Roddy had the turkey this year, and then the Nards guy and Kevin, you guys had the trimmings.
Oh, great. I hold up my end of the bargain. I wait online at the Sputtery. I went to Librettery on La Brea. Why do you give the turkey to Hot Rod?
Don't call me Hot Rod. I confess, I forgot to preheat the oven, okay? There, I've said it.
You know, my friend Robbie DiCicco got wicked bad scurvy from eating a raw Cornish game hen that was underprepared.
More importantly, what are you guys thankful for this year? Rod?
Well, you know, Craig, The Price is Right is celebrating 30 years this year. Oh,
that's nice.
Craig, the money just keeps rolling in.
Yeah, what do you get paid in sexy jackets?
What?
Kevin, what are you thankful for this year?
I'm thankful that I get to leave right after I eat.
Once again, I'm thankful I'm not that guy slamming his nads into a pole.
You know what? This is ridiculous. I did my part, okay? I didn't undercook the potatoes.
You didn't cook the potatoes. The Sputtery cooked the potatoes at one of their five famous locations.
Okay, stop with the five locations.
Thank God you can't undercook a Jack and Coke.
You know, I mentioned clips earlier. I think Anna's got a clip from her video. Anna? Notice that, I think that's a Persian rug. It's very expensive.
Give anything to be that red ball.
My thermometer just popped.
That was a nice clip. We've had two wonderful clips during dinner. This is great.
Yeah, this is real great. You know what? How about enough of the clips and a little bit more eating? Why don't we kick the eating off? When
Kevin,
does that happen?
Kevin, hey, Jay, are you telling me you're not having a great time?
No, I'm not having a great time, okay? The food is undercooked, yeah, and I'm sitting next to the Miami Dolphins in Vegas right here.
Hey, this jack is getting louder by the minute,
and I don't need this.
This bird is
undercooked. Look at this guy, okay? He's over here babbing and bat.
Wait a second. Guys, please,
Beverly Hills.
Yeah.
Guys, you're not going to bring me down this year, okay, guys? Because I'm in love.
I hear you, Craig. I feel the same way. I, too, am also, in addition to you, in love.
You got a special lady?
Yeah.
I, too, have a special lady, Craig.
Yeah, well, maybe you should have let her cook. Yeah.
What?
Guys, not again. Guys.
I'm sorry, Rod. Right. Craig's right. I've got something to be thankful for. I, too, have a special lady.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
KJ, what's her name?
Well, her name... That's not important. What I call her Sugar.
And wait a second. You call her Sugar?
Yeah.
I call mine Sugar.
Me too.
No,
Sugar.
No.
I swear to God.
This is special.
I call mine Sugar too.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Does anyone have a microphone?
I got one right here.
Sugar. Oh, honey, honey. You are my candy girl. You got me wanting you. Ah, sugar. Yo, honey, honey. You are my candy girl. And you got me wanting you. Ah, sugar.
Tonight. Tonight, a very special Late Late Show, a roundtable discussion concerning the Letterman-Bush interview with a distinguished panel. Martin Mull, Mike Grayson, from The Price is Right, Rod Roddy, and live from Stuttgart, Anna Kournikova. There will be emotions, there will be opinions, and we've been promised pretzels. Next. We are waiting now to go. We're going to go live to a roundtable discussion. Let me first go over the rules. They are simple. First, no interrupting, no name-calling, and everyone must respect the other's personal space. Please don't get all up in my face. Nobody makes jokes about Rod Roddy's jacket. Martin Mull is not allowed to talk about art. Rod Roddy is not allowed to turn his jacket on. And this is a deal breaker, absolutely no unloading about a hockey star boyfriend. Okay, let's get underway.
Okay.
Let's get started. What did you guys think about the rules?
I felt they were adequate, especially given the alleged panelists here. I'm glad you were able to brush over them.
Brush, that's an art reference.
Okay.
That's an art reference.
I'm glad you were able to sketch them out.
That's a Marty.
I get the picture.
Marty, stop, move forward. Rod Roddy.
I'm not participating, Craig. My agent told me that this was a town hall meeting, not a round table.
This is a round table. This is a Bavarian oak round table. Anna, what are your thoughts, Anna? Mike Grayson.
I thought the rules sucked, Craig. I mean, you're laying out a bunch of rules. I have no idea what they mean. Martin Mull can't talk about art. What does that mean?
Rod?
Yes?
Your thoughts on who won tonight?
Talk to the hand, Craig. I'm not participating. This is a roundtable discussion, and I was here for a town hall.
Mike Grayson?
I mean, I thought the whole thing sucked.
And apparently Rod Roddy is not participating in the roundtable.
That's fine. I mean, what do I care if Rod Roddy's got something to say about the... What's he going to tell us about the debate? That Del Monte peas cost 69 cents a can?
Talk to the hand, Mike. I'm not participating.
Craig, this whole thing sucks. I mean, we got Rod Roddy here. The guy knows nothing. Martin Mull, he just wants to talk about it. The guy hasn't been on Letterman in 6 to 8 years.
Yeah,
it's sad.
We got that.
It's sad. We don't want to hear about it anymore.
We kid.
We're just talking about politics, and it's turning into this thing. She's not talking. He's not talking.
I'm not participating.
He doesn't know anything
about
politics. All right, listen, listen. Wait. Mike Grayson. Gentlemen, when I hold a round table, I like it to be positive. I like it to be uplifting. Can you say anything positive, please, Mike?
I kind of like that song, That's What Friends Are For, by Elton John, Stevie Wonder, Gladys Knight, and Dionne Warwick.
Keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me. For sure, that's what friends are for good times. And bad times, I'll be on your side forevermore. That's what friends are for. Keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me. For sure,
I don't need for sure.
That's what friends are for. For good times and bad times, I'll be on your side forevermore. Oh, I tell you, that's what friends are for.
We'll be right back after this.
Keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me. For sure,
for sure.
That's what friends are for. For good times and bad times, I'll be on your side forever.
Raise your hand if you have any questions in the live audience here. Just raise your hand, and now we just go with some questions. How about that guy up there? Guy way up in the back.
Craig, how much would you say a brand new Chevy Malibu costs?
I don't know. Why do you ask?
Because I do. But when I was down at The Price is Right, they didn't pick me.
Oh, they didn't call you down. That's too bad. I'm sorry. I suppose you came up here to see our little program to cheer yourself up and get some laughs. Is that right?
No, actually, this guy dragged me here.
Oh. Hey, I just thought of something. I have a great idea. how would you like to be called down right here on our show? You know? And you'll hear your name, and I'll call out your name, and then you run down the aisle, and the audience will go crazy. Huh? That sounds like fun.
No thanks.
No. Oh, seriously, this will be fun. This will be fun. I want to do it. I'm excited now. What's your name, buddy?
My name's Kip Madsen.
Kip Madsen?
Yeah.
Doesn't exactly roll off the tongue, but I'm going to try. I'm going to try this. I kind of like this. Kip Madsen, come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Thanks anyway, but it's just not the same.
What did he say? What did he say? What happened?
No, it's not that. It's just.
It's not. It's my voice. My voice isn't good enough. Is that the problem, buddy?
No, I just.
Maybe you want me to wear one of those loud, obnoxious jackets like that guy does with the big fake voice that guy has, that announcer has. Is that what you want?
Oh, Craig, perhaps you should let a pro handle this, okay? Are you ready? Kip Madsen, come on down! You're the next contestant on The Price is Right! All right, Kip! You did it, you did it! How about that? By the way, Craig, in the future, stick to the bad Shaq jokes, okay?
Thank you, Rod.
Good night,
Roddy, everybody. Let's check the news. Here we go. Tonight, on a very special Late Late Show, our annual Thanksgiving Roundtable with my family, TV star, movie star, now author Tom Triple Threat Arnold. From The Price is Right, Rod, Hot Rod Roddy. Live from New York City, Sports Illustrated swimsuit model Petra Nemkova, and yet to arrive from Suddenly Susan, Kathy Griffin. There will be emotions, there will be opinions, and Tom Arnold brought a ham. It's all coming up next.
Oh, gorgeous Hollywood Hills, Los Angeles, California. It's the Late Late Show with Craig Kilborn.
We're now, I guess we're ready to start the roundtable as soon as the host arrives, and I think Kilborn is the host, and I believe he's arriving right now. Let's join the fun. Welcome to the Thanksgiving Roundtable, and again, let's meet my family. This is kind of nice. TV star, author, and the man who brought a ham to a Thanksgiving dinner, it's Tommy Arnold. Tom Arnold. From The Price is Right, Rod Hot Rod Roddy. And from Suddenly Susan, Kathy Tardy Griffin. She ain't here yet. And joining us live from New York City, Sports Illustrated swimsuit model, Petra Nemkova. Hey, Petra, can you hear me? Hello? Apparently, we're having some satellite difficulties. This is great. She can't hear me, and Kathy Griffin is late.
Yeah, why would Kathy be late? Wasn't Suddenly Susan canceled 5 years ago?
Hey, now, Tom, no bad-mouthing Suddenly Susan until Kathy actually gets here, okay?
Okay.
Which brings me to the rules. Rule number one, like every year, don't make fun of Rod's jacket. This year, I guess that applies to Tom as well.
Craig, Rod promised me he was not going to wear that jacket.
Hey, I never promised. That's my trademark.
What's it? Do your trademark? No, your trademark is, y'all come down here.
I thank you, mean, come on down.
Can you quit doing that, Craig?
Yeah, rule number two, Rod is not to yell, come on down, unless he's provoked.
Wow. Yeah, well, meanwhile, I look like a gay float in the Macy's parade. Craig, this jacket is an insult to me because I'm a big-time writer now. You know what I mean? By the way, my new book.
Rule number three, Tom. You're not allowed to promote your book except once during this meal. Is this your one time? Think about it, buddy.
No, I'm going to wait till Kathy gets here.
I thought so, yeah. Rule number four, Kathy Griffin cannot embark on her typical name-dropping rampages. She does it all the time. Every time she does it this time, $10. She owes the table
$10. Hey, you guys, sorry I'm late. Did I miss anything? Wow, Macy's has two gay floats this year, huh? Hey, Tom, good to see you. Hey, will you do that thing you do? Hey, come on down to the front, y'all.
Listen, Missy, it's come on down.
Don't call me Missy.
Oh, well.
Hey, Craig, I thought you said Rod wouldn't be doing that anymore.
Well, he was provoked, but Rod, you gotta watch it. Now, Kathy Griffin,
yeah.
Why were you late?
I am so sorry. Hollywood Squares was having a big party, and Shatner really had me backed into a square.
Guess what? You owe us $10 for that.
Wow.
$10.
I knew you were cheap. I have to pay to have Thanksgiving dinner here?
No, every time you name drop, $10 to the table.
You think I'm a name dropper?
$10 now
on
the table.
All right, fine. Oh, you think I'm bad? You should see Tom Cruise.
20, 20, 20, 20.
Well, I guess I'm lucky there are no celebrities here.
Well.
Who's that?
That is the swimsuit model from Sports Illustrated, the lovely Petra Nemkova.
Hi, Petra. Does it speak?
We're actually having technical difficulties.
No, I think she's just ignoring me, okay? All models do. Jealous bitches.
Kathy, it's a satellite problem. Anyway, those are the rules. More importantly, after the meal, we're going to retire to my great room.
Oh.
Great room. Craig, you know, I've been to this house, and there isn't a single great room in this dump.
Tom, I beg to differ because there is a very lovely guest bathroom, and I've spent a lot of time there.
Please don't ever say that again. No, the great room, that's what we call the family rooms nowadays. It's fun. We're going to play some games in there, including charades.
Charades
sucks, Craig.
Tom, it's only because you're no good at it.
I'm not bad.
Tom, you're awful. You are awful, man.
Wow.
At Halloween, I cheated, and you still couldn't get the clue.
By the way, my new book is called How I Lost 5 Pounds in 6 Years. It makes a wonderful gift, and it's available at all major bookstores.
Wait a second. Let me guess the price. This is kind of fun. I'm going to say your book is $19.99. Kathy, your guess?
All right, let me think. I got a free copy of my friend Jerry Seinfeld's book.
$10.
Fine. $25.
Rod?
Yes, Craig.
What's the price of the book?
Craig, the price of that new book is $24.95.
Then I win.
Kathy, you actually went over.
By 5 cents?
Those are the rules. The Price is Right rules.
Whoa. The Price is Right rules? He didn't even yell the come on down, y'all, or whatever.
Hey, that's come on down. Get
you
it?
Hey,
why'd you still say that, Craig?
Sexist.
You promised
that is the way to make a living.
Well, that's a dumb way to make a living.
You've got it.
Hold on, everybody. Stop. Stop.
Well, happy Ramadan. This is a farce.
You guys look great in those jackets. Float boys, and I don't care if it's come on down or come on down, fellas, it blows. And you and I both know that. And you were late. You know you were late. And don't pull Shatner on me. Shatner doesn't like redheads. He likes everything but redheads.
I find it hurtful that you imply that William Shatner would not hit on me.
Time out. Kathy, did you fart?
This Thanksgiving is horrible. It is a debacle.
Hey, I could have gone to Brad and Jennifer's house.
That's two more, Red. $20 on the table.
I'm tapped out.
Hello, Craig.
Oh, Petra. You can hear me. How are you?
I'm great. What about you?
Well, not so great, actually. Thanks for asking. I invited some friends over for Thanksgiving dinner, and it hasn't turned out well at all.
Okay, see you later, alligator.
Wait, Petra. That's it?
In a while, crocodile.
Another Thanksgiving ruin. Last year, Hasselhoff fell asleep in the yams.
Craig, it's not so bad. Come on.
Yeah, cheer up, okay? You're really, really good at charades.
Yeah.
Thanks, but no thanks. I'll be honest. I threw the party, and yet I have soured on Thanksgiving this year.
Soured?
Yeah. Hmm.
Well, Craig, I've got an idea how to sweeten things up.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, Craig. It's your favorite.
Get with it.
All right.
Come on,
I
Craig.
Guess so.
Sugar. Honey,
you are my candy girl, and you got me wanting you. I just can't believe the loneliness of loving you. I just can't believe it's true. I just can't believe the wonder I was feeling too. I just can't believe it's true. Sugar, oh, honey, you are my candy girl, and you've got me wanting you.
Happy Thanksgiving, everyone.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving.
fabulous being in Las Vegas. I've always wanted to play Las Vegas. You know that. I was here earlier in the year for the introduction of the Price is Right slot machines. That was last year, by the way, almost a year ago. Love that. Love this. Now we're playing the big room. Here it is.
Donna Zippelfelder, come on down. And Roth, come on down.
For showcase number two, we have $5,300. All right. Now, on television at this point, you know we always take a commercial. And the actual retail price of your showcase is $3,745. You are a winner with a difference over only $1,555. Congratulations, Donna.
I have played. I came in last night and I played it for the first time. I must tell you that they have captured every nuance of The Price is Right. If you ever wanted to be on The Price is Right, you feel like you're on The Price is Right. There are showcases on there. We have the mountain climber on there that goes, yo, to let ego. You let the one that falls off the cliff. Everybody loves that. The wheel is the wonderful thing. The big wheel, that's included. And it spins right in front of you, just like people spin it. It goes up, and then it comes down. It's really an amazing machine. They've done a fabulous job with it. I'm really thrilled with it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll get out of your way.
All right.
Welcome to The Price is Right.
It's me!
One more time. Oh, so we got a combination
right
here. And I paid six. Do it again. Raise it again.
Go, girl.
Oh, there you go again. You got two this time.
Another game.
Heather, do it.
You'll be going all over the country for this?
Yes, I will. Harrah's has casinos all over the country, as you know. And we have fans all over the country. It's going to work out because I'll be able to go out and see people in person and show them how to play this machine in person at all the different casinos owned by Harrah's. And I'm really looking forward to it because I love to travel and I love to meet people who watch The Price is Right.
You know him as the clown prince of The Price is Right, the game show announcer whose daily message is to come on down to win fabulous prizes. But tonight, Rod Roddy has a message that could save your life. Roddy is in the hospital tonight. He's recovering from his second surgery for colon cancer.
And he wants you to learn from his mistakes. He didn't get tested until it was almost too late. The new doctor on our staff at KDKA interviewed Roddy last spring in L.A. as Roddy recovered from his first operation. And Dr. Paul Nemiroff talked to Roddy again this week about how the second surgery went and what doctors are saying about his future. Dr. Paul, welcome.
Thank you. It's great to be here. Rod Roddy would tell you that even though he's in the hospital recovering from a very serious operation, he's a lucky man. He is alive, he should recover, and he has some advice to help you avoid what he's going through.
He may be a star of The Price is Right, but that didn't protect Rod Roddy against a disease that kills 60,000 Americans each year. Like all cancers, early detection is the key. I asked Rod why he put off getting a colonoscopy for 17 years.
Why didn't I do it? I didn't do it for the same reason that everybody else doesn't do it.
Rod told me he was just too busy and it was an inconvenience.
But believe me, it's an inconvenience that I really wish at this point that I had taken. Because had I done that, I would have saved myself the hospital visits, the chemotherapy, all the doctor's visits. My life has become a medical appointment.
After Rod's first surgery, his doctor told me Rod could have died.
He was bleeding, he was obstructed, and he was being transfused.
Mm-hmm. So had he lost a lot of blood?
He had lost a lot of blood. And, we operated on him emergently.
Rod ultimately did quite well, up until a few weeks ago when a scan noted a new mass in his colon. He needed another operation last week and is recuperating in a hospital in Los Angeles.
How are you feeling?
I feel pretty good. I'm a little bit sore, but I'm fine.
I asked him about concerns that the cancer had spread to his liver.
This time, it did not go into the liver, and I'm saved again. So I was really, really lucky.
Rod hopes to be back at work at The Price is Right in a few weeks. And just as he told me when we talked earlier this year, he'll be pushing early detection.
If there was one thing you could say to people that might be worried about colon cancer, what would you say?
Oh, that's simple. I'd simply say, come on down and get your colonoscopy. It could save your life.